Hello, Gart.
Oh, you're up. It's good to see you back on your feet. Did you like your room? I cleaned it for you.
He looks you over. I did, thank you. Big improvement. You're welcome. I thought it'd be nice for you to wake up in a clean place after you, let's be fair, defended this establishment and its clientele from gunfire. I give credit where credit is due, and that, sir, was a nice shot. I was watching until you hit him. Crawled inside then. Bullets started flying. Anyway, he clears his throat. I wish you a quick recovery. Also, he raises his finger, you and your partner are staying here free now. This establishment supports cops. The stay is free. The drinks are not, he adds. Just felt I needed to specify that. Where did everyone go? Oh, you know. Looks around at the empty place. People don't tend to stick out around after shootouts. Turns out they're not good for business. What happened to the man with the sunglasses? He shakes his head. I don't remember everyone who comes here, and many people wear sunglasses inside lately. Must be a fad. Okay, so I have to mention, when it happened, you were right out there on the balcony. Yeah, I was. Yeah. He nods. Try to remain aloof. That's because I'm a badass. Yeah, I guess you are a badass. Yeah, I don't know. He feels the need to explain himself. Clients were panicking, and also, I guess I sort of found out that I don't care if I die. Empathy says he means it. He's not just boasting. It's something he discovered about himself stepping onto that balcony. All right, thanks. No problem. Looks around at the empty establishment. They'll come back. They always do. Well, this guy's still here. You know what, though? We can try the mirror again. Since that's our room. Let's try it. I don't know how long we shouldn't run. Or if it really makes a difference. Dig deep into your mind to locate the source of the expression. Damn it. Like the rest of you, it comes from a bad place somewhere in the past. That's all you know for now. I don't want to put points into encyclopedia. I have enough. So we can stay there again, but I don't think there's any reason to. We're going to go to that island. And then who knows what. Now this guy. Yeah, it's not empty. Is Titus here? Is that Titus? That's locked. Never mind. I don't know who that guy is or why he just says it's all about money. Maybe he's the killer. Is that you, Titus? Seeing you approach, the bruised man raises his beer in welcome.
Crazy motherfucker. Didn't think you had that fury in you, but I guess I've misjudged a lot of people lately.
He lets out a whistle.
That was one hell of a shot. Hell of a shot. The fucks did not expect that.
He looks at you with unmistakable respect.
I guess what I'm trying to say here is thank you for intervening, fellas. That was mighty brave of you.
He extends his hand. Authority says, this is big. It's as big of a thank you as Titus Hardy can muster under any circumstances. No need to thank me, just doing my job. Well, cheers anyway, Copper. He raises his whiskey bottle in salute. I'm sorry about the people you lost. His bruised face stiffens. Theo was old. I think he'd be pretty happy with the way he went. Never could imagine him withering away on a sickbed. But Lizzie and Angus? He gulps. They were just stupid kids. Didn't realize the crap they got into before it was too late. I feel responsible for both. For all of them, really. Empathy says, here it comes. The last one is the worst one. He only deals with it by drinking copious amounts of 8% beer. And Glenn. Glenn was my friend. Best I've ever had. I love that crazy homo like my own brother. He takes a sip of his beer. We're all screwed without him, but what do? This job is crap. Hold on, what about that Shanky fella? Well, he ran away, didn't he? Dennis, you saw him run. He's a mean little crap, and I never trusted him. He shakes his head. He better run real fast now. Real fast. They were good people. I'm sorry it went down like that. Well, yeah. Memento mori, right? What does that mean? It means you might die tomorrow, so live every day like it's your last. Ain't that right, fellows? Absolutely, Alan says. Today I'm going to get drunk, eat good food, and bet a good-looking gal, because tomorrow a motor carriage might run me over. Eugene says, oh, you might die of a heart failure or a syphilis? Hey, hey, screw you for ruining a beautiful idea. What's going to happen to Hardy Boys now? First, we're going to find Dennis. I'm going to find Dennis, Ellen interjects. I'm going to find him, and then I'm going to kill him. Rhetoric says, the tone of the statement is so matter-of-fact, it's as though he was talking about picking up a morning newspaper on his daily walk around the block. That's not going to bring back... he nods without really listening. We're hunting that rat down. Let it be known what happens to cowards. And then, he thinks for a moment, I guess I'll take a closer look at our union members. There's bound to be some ambitious fellows who'd love nothing more than advancing social democracy by busting some heads. Might even ask Tibbs if he's tired of replacing windows and maybe he wants to have some fun with his brother. He pauses. Anyway, don't you worry. As long as Titus Hardy's standing, there will be Hardy Boys. Do you know what happened to Classier? Don't know. Don't care. I'll be glad if I never see that woman again. Titus, after all we've been through, level with me. You really liked her, didn't you? Nope. Drama says, he did. Okay, got it. He nods and takes another sip of whiskey. Any idea what I should do now? Judging by the sight of you, he looks at your bandages, I was just crawling into bed with a bottle of whiskey in one hand and a big boob in the other. Alan says, yeah, go pay Monica a visit in Jamrock. She's got a knack for making men forget about their worries. Biggest pair of milkers in all of Revachol. Eugene says, hell, you both look like you could use some feminine company right now. Thank you for your advice, Eugene, Kim says. And you too, Alan. I do always appreciate a good use of the expression milkers. Frederick says, it sincerely amuses him how hard these guys typecast themselves. You're welcome, Bino Clard. Titus's response is completely unironic. You're all right in my book. So long, fellows. Be good, so I don't have to come back here again. Take care, coppers, he says with a warm smile. You two look after yourselves now. Death passed on you today, but men don't get that lucky twice. Ellen nods to you and then to the lieutenant. Capo Loco, and the normal cop, I guess. Good luck in Jamrock. Scars make the best tattoos, they say. Eugene says, thanks for getting involved, guys. Not a lot of cops would step in that line of fire, but you did. Titus says, and if you ever feel like the uniform is holding you back, I've got a few vacancies. You'd make one hard Hardy boy, copper. Esprit de Corps says, and Titus Hardy himself would make a good officer. That man was born to lead. Alright, fine. We didn't go for this before, but... He's actually okay, Titus. The RCM could really use a man like you, Titus. Think about it. I will, Capo. It's a promise. He puts his can down. Now scoot, because the Hardy boys got some mourning and drinking to do. Kim says, take it easy on the drink. The danger is not past. This town needs you on your feet. Good point, Bonaclard. Hardy looks at his beer. We'll keep the vol under 12% tonight. Now, if I talk to this guy,
Hey, it's you again. I've been thinking about it, and you know what? We're both cops. This city is big enough for two cops.
He smiles, more than a bit drunk now. So I thought by talking to him, we'd actually talk to him, not Titus. Because you can click him, but not Eugene. That's Eugene, right?
Okay, three cops. Me, you, and your little friend here.
He looks at you, at the lieutenant. He gives you a quick two-finger salute. All right. Well, he's drunk right now, so... All right, turning off the music. Oh, it's the voiceover now. Okay, oh, look at that. Un jour je serai le retour something. Presditor. One day I will return to your side. The graffiti has been painted over the traces of the fight that took place here. It smells of blood and heavy fuel oil. Reaction Speed says, this was Cindy the Skull. Looks like Cindy the Skull finally found the words for her masterpiece. The lieutenant crouches, touching the fuel oil with his finger. Looks like it, yes. It's still fresh. It wasn't here yesterday. I smell heavy fuel oil. And blood. Some of it is even yours. Interfacing says, heavy fuel oil? Isn't that flammable? What are you trying to imply at, Fingers? You could buy some smokes. Light up a ciggy and throw it in there, you know, just to see what happens. See if it's flammable. It's better that way. Safer. Okay. Light the graffiti on fire with a burning cigarette. What it says on the can. Okay. Alright, check to see if we're La Puta Madre's man. Since we're right here. Precinct 57, we've been attacked. I repeat, Lieutenant Kitsuragi and... Something is wrong. Only static hisses through the speaker. Hello? No reply. Only the mindless drone of static crawling through the air. It's been this way for a while now, the lieutenant shrugs. My guess is the Union is listening in on our conversations and jamming outward communications to protect themselves from Krennel. It only happens when someone mentions the attack. The rest is unaffected. Our best bet is to carry on like nothing happened, that is if we don't want us cut off the grid completely. Isn't that dangerous? No more dangerous than stepping between three armed mercenaries and eight Union men, I hope. He glances over his shoulder. I don't like it either, but that's the way it is. The streets seem safe enough to me. If anything, taking out the mercs made things calmer. For now. He flicks off the radio. Silence. You can try calling again. Just don't mention the tribunal. And remember, they're listening in. Perception hearing says, everything sounds okay. No drumbeat of total war yet. If anything, everything sounds too okay. Reconnect me to the 41st. She sighs. Right, please hold. Jules. 10-4, come in. He hesitates. Fireworker. Over. Jules, I've heard that some people think of me as a La Puta Madre's peon. Do you think I'm corrupted? 10-4, sir. There's a pause as he seems to mull it all over behind his enormous radio microphone. Well, there's been some talk, sir. He finally says reluctantly. Some talk? What does it even mean, there's been some talk? Do they think I'm corrupt or not? I only meant that there's been some talk in the station, that's all. But there's always some talk in the station. You know how our officers in Jamrock are. Task complete. But then again, some of us are truly on the take. It's unfortunate. Over. Listen, I've actually lost my gun, too. 10-4, I know. I already wrote it in a report, but he hesitates. It will stay on my desk for a few days. Over. I have successfully located my gun. It's on me now, and I won't lose it again. 10-4, sir. Roger that. I'm very glad to hear it. I will make relevant changes to the report. 10-10. Alright, well, there you have it. Some of us are on a take. That doesn't really answer my question, though. So it's Monday now. Oh, wow. Yeah, so I just realized. Yeah, Saturday is when the whole shootout happened. We were out Sunday, and now it's Monday. Let me talk to this guy.
My man, you're alive. Almost. Kind of. Sort of alive.
He assesses the situation. I've been better. Man, what a day. I missed out on most of the action, but I heard it was quite the encounter, he nods thoughtfully, and a strong sense of finality to it. So what's next? You guys heading back to Jamrock now? Talk is local union muscle were behind it all. I'd reckon the case is closed, even if it kind of turned into a bleep show. Let's look around. It wasn't a local union muscle, by the way. Hey, that's just what I heard. Old wives' tale. So, what's next? I'm still looking around. Loose threads to tie up. Good luck with that, my man. Ain't easy being you, but hey, you're still breathing, right? By the way, you're not angry with me anymore? Screw it, he shrugs. I'm a bad guy now. This thing's more important than holding a grudge. It's okay. You've been through enough. We are what we are, and you're a cop. I met the lady driver in my investigation. She's called Ruby. Okay. He seems a little apprehensive. Chama says, is it wise to share information about the case like this, sire? The lieutenant throws you a quick glance. Okay, I guess I'll stop. Esprit de Corps says, what are you doing? Yeah, that's it. Can't share anymore. That's probably for the best. You keep your job to yourself. With a job like yours, you have to. Checking in on people. The old lady over here. Jeez, we're like walking all over. Is she still over here? Yeah, she gone? We can run now, I hope? I'm gonna chance it. Got some ground to cover. Well, these guys are all gone. Look at that. There he is. Call me mañana. The Boyardero stares at you with respect, then gestures toward the trickles of blood adorning your clothes. Yeah, I got shot. No big deal. Yet you live, he nods approvingly. It calls back to an older era where this was commonplace. You have a true Boyardero heart. Right, so where is everyone? Hiding, gathering themselves. The harbor's in full lockdown, friend. No getting in or out, for the time being. You can't help me get inside? Nah, man, not today. Today is war. Redrick says he says it matter-of-factly, like it's no big deal. What's going to happen next? Time will tell, he shrugs. I'll tell Everard you stopped by. I'm sure he'll be glad. What will you be doing now? I'll be okay here, doing lookout. He surveys the red flags draped from the harbor gates. Quite the sight, aren't they? Getting to like that red, I am. Yeah, I noticed that. Don't worry about me. I live to alleviate the worries of our brothers. See if any other insane killers turn up. Then I'll run and live. Try not to get shot, huh? I'm sure I'll be luckier than you, friend. His grin is as wide as a desert. So we can't get up, apparently. Locked off again is Measurehead here. Yep, locked. Not even the button. We can't press the button. All right. Well, that's that. Oh, you buy something at Frit, right? A cigarette? A burning cigarette.
Is this about the questions again? Because I don't really know anything.
Cigarettes. We could use some of this stuff. Duramine? I need Duramine. Plus one morale. I have a lot of morale stuff. Hypnogamma's plus three morale. We're good. Plus one physique, minus one morale. Smokes Astra. Plus one intellect, minus one health. Give me Astra cigarettes. Here you go, mister. These grad-made cigarettes are remarkable for their high tar content, a favorite of fishermen, police officers, and working men the world over. So I'm not sure I'm gonna burn this thing. It seems very dramatic, but it's in our quest log. Step back, Lieutenant. Set it on fire with a lit cigarette. Oh boy. The fuel oil catches fire immediately with an ominous hiss. A bright orange flash across the surface of the letters. Black smoke rises from the burning message. This is me saying this? Disco Elysium. The lieutenant has taken a small step back. He looks at your face, illuminated by the flames, and nods silently. Then the fire falters. Empathy says the flames warmed him too, not at all in a bad way. Let's go to that island, Kim says. Slowly the flames subside, the fuel burning out. The air still smells of mazout and springtime. Well, that was interesting. Check the island. Murder weapon? I don't know. Maybe we'll find the murder weapon on the island. I didn't go to the island, and I don't know about Dolores Day here. Oh, this guy here. Maybe a sea monster did this to the plaza? A sea monster. He was, like, right here for everything.
Mon Dieu, you set it on fire. What kind of policeman are you?
He looks at the plaza. I walk in the flames. A beacon of light in the dull shores of mediocrity. You're welcome, Martinez. Oh, well, thank you, officer. It's certainly light in the mood. He laughs nervously. Very cozy, like a little street fair almost. Figured that's something to say about the shooting, but no. About the library. Anything new here? This might be the last time we are here.
Oh my god! Things have gotten out of hand! I thought the psychic stuff was bad, but the crime, it's even worse. I haven't been able to come to work for 3 days. The shop has been locked, no sales, gangbangers running around, shooting everyone. I know I shouldn't have bought a shop in this ghetto.
That's not true. You were here on Saturday and now it's Monday. So you missed one day then. Hey, I'm the one who got shot here, in the leg and in the shoulder. Oh my god, even the police can't take care of all this. Just look at you. You're a wreck. Someone should do something about this. She rubs her pendant between two fingers, thinking. Maybe I should close the bookstore and open a psychic studio. Yes, she nods to herself. It makes sense. Crime is the sixth element, you see. The darkest element. I could teach people to protect themselves against bad energies and to fight crime. Honestly, I'm not sure what to think of it. No, no, you're right, officer. You've convinced me. It is a great idea. Thank you for the inspiration. In the meantime, do buy the books, as many as you can. They won't be here for much longer. Determination shines in her eyes. Is there anything else I can help you with? I don't think there's anything else to buy. I bought it all.
Hi, Ace Detective. Are you here for more books?
Let's see if there's any more added, just in case. Should I talk to the dice maker? Nothing else to buy, lady. All right. Let's talk to the... You know, that's the long way around, isn't it? Or is it? I think they're both kind of long ways, isn't it? I'm not sure. I'm sure she heard the, smells like leather and sweat. Kim?
It's dark.
The lieutenant states the obvious. And the flashlight works a lot better if you hold it in your hand. Fair point, yes, totally obvious. Right, now let's get to it, the lieutenant nods. I know about the flashlight. Alright, how do I get over to this lady? Wait, no. This way. Wait. That's not the way. See if she has anything new to say. No, that's funny. Okay. I thought Kim had something interesting he wanted to say. I seem to be fine with running now. Oh, should I check in with Kuno? Kuno must have loved that. Forgot about him for a second. If he's still back here. He is.
Everyone says you started crying in the middle of a firefight and then bled like a pig. I guess that was cool.
He shrugs. Who's saying that? People. They said you kind of died for a moment. That you let your crap out already, but then came back. So I guess that's what's cool now. You don't think because you got half your bleep shot off and you're an invalid now, Kuno's gonna treat you any different. Kuno doesn't reward weakness, he says, looking at your pathetic limp. It's business as usual with Kuno. Kuno's cold like that. Pain threshold says, feels good for some reason. Watch out, pig. It's a dangerous world out there, but Kuno's got his eyes on you. What's that supposed to mean? Kuno starts doing the I got my eye on you gesture repeatedly. Who knows? Hi.
I'll die before I squeal, pig.
Alright. Then I'd recommend not squealing. They're just checking everyone again before we go to the island. This guy. Forgot about him.
Wow.
Wow, what?
A cop limping down the street, bleeding from the shoulder, face bruised, looking like hell? You know what that is?
Pain.
Cool. That's cool.
He nods and settles back into the pile of boxes. All right. That was interesting. Pawn shop.